cruise. Nothing but bad dudes from Richmond to bad news. Make fast moves, dog. Stay alert here. Catch them up top, come down and drop work here. Home of the Grizzly, we live to get paid until I'm old and grizzly. This is where I stizzy. Born and raised from the cradle to the grave. And the V to the V to the V to the is A.
Is A.
Buckle your seatbelts, hold on tight. You know we had to do a remix, right? It's the best of both worlds, yeah, you know what we about. It's the bottom of the north and the top of the south. You dealing with some bosses, we ain't too fond of taking losses. You come around here, better be cautious. We coming with the forces of 500 horses, but we ain't under the hood. We come from the hood. Let's get one thing understood. We ain't no country bumpkins, so please don't make no assumptions. We ain't too city to get crunk and gritty. At first they ain't hit me, so I brought some friends with me.
That's right.
And everybody's repping the beat, dog. It's going down like fat kids on a seesaw. Next up,
I believe that's me.
Hey, yo, Quan, can you hold me down?
Definitely. A lot of niggas been talking. Sooner or later, police gonna have to choke them. Bad news, we on that bully shit often. Serving hard soft and pop shit and hop your in the crowd on bail, fresh out of jail. VA screaming. Soon as I stepped on the scene, niggas got to flee. Cause not only do I rap and sing, I really clap that thing. And outside of Jesus, I'm born to be the king of kings. Keep my crown fitted, keep my throne straight. I want the whole world, my own state. Y'all just stepped on, I got that raw weight. My shit's all real, y'all shit's all fake. And I can tell it when I see these. They talk like me, but really wanna be me.
Creep on in, on in, on in. See, I'm riding high. Kinda broke the scene, y'all, so all I got is fire.
Player, give me some brew and I might just chill, but I'm the type that likes to light another joint like Cypress Hill.
Man Talk Monday, welcome back to the show. I'm good, man. I'm good. This type of thing just bothers me, man. And you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. I don't have any problem with new style or different way to do things. You know, I believe in being able to grow as a people, as a sport, whatever it may be, man. But, I mean, within reason, isn't it too much to ask for that I buy a ticket and I watch you play? Is it too much to ask for that you buy a ticket to watch your team play and you watch the players that you came and you paid your ticket to come see? Huh? Hey, seriously, is it too much to ask a rapper to put together a couple of lines that are coherent? Right. Is that too much to ask for? Is that too much to ask for that you put together a couple of lines that rhyme, that possibly tell a story instead of just a bunch of, you know, sounds like you're having a freaking conniption? Seizure or something like that? Is it too much to ask for? That's all I'm saying. I'm telling you, man, we have really used that term, and I've been talking about this for 10 years. Like, this started probably like 10 years ago. We have really used this term, hater, as a crutch. Like we have really used this term as a crutch in our society. Oh, so-and-so is a hater. Why? Just because I disagree with you? Just because I think what you're doing is bullshit and I'm saying it? We should just keep it to ourselves? Oh, you're just a hater. No, I just call out bullshit when I see it. Oh, whatever, man. Whatever. Like, when did that happen? When did we stop keeping it real? Everybody's so sensitive in their feelings. Man, get over it. Get over it, please. Your rhymes suck, And it sucks that I paid all this money to come see LeBron play, and LeBron's sitting on the end of the damn bench in some jeans. That sucks. There's a lot of other things that sucks, too, that they'll tell you that are okay in 2017. And I'm here to tell you that that's a goddamn lie. Period. I'm sorry. I don't care. I don't care. This is my damn show. Talk about what the hell I want to talk about. I keep it real as much as I can, much as I want to. Period. Let's talk some entertainment. What's today's date? March 20th, 2017. Celebrating birthdays today. Turning 58 years of age, man. Wrestler Sting. I remember when Sting hit the scene, man. That was big news back in probably like 79, 80. This was very weird. I'm looking at a picture of Sting without his face paint on. It's kind of creeping me out. But Sting was kind of like the new generation, man. He was kind of like the new wave. Sting turns 58 years old today. Happy birthday to him. Also celebrating his 60th birthday, man. Spike Lee, Mookie turning 60 years, Mars Blackman, Spike Lee turns 60 years of age today. Wow, 60 years of age today. We should have done a top five Spike Lee something. Do we still got time to do it? Maybe we can. Let me think about it for a second. Spike Lee, man. Big fan of Spike Lee. 60 years of age today. He has some things to say about Colin Kaepernick. We'll get to that here in a second. Ironically, Spike Lee turns 60. Happy birthday to him. Speaking of NBA, Jamal Crawford turns 37 years of age today. Happy birthday to Jamal Crawford, one-time Atlanta Hawk. I think he still plays for the Clippers. Great player. Great player. I think there's a stat. Jamal Crawford is like the only player in NBA history, or one of the few, maybe it's him and Wilt Chamberlain, that have scored over 50 points for three or four different teams. I got to find that stat. But Jamal Crawford turns 37 years of age. Happy birthday to him. Great player. Good player. Very good player. And also, if he didn't die back in 2003... Fred Rogers, a.k.a. Mr. Rogers, from Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, would have celebrated a birthday today. Rest in peace, Mr. Fred Rogers. Man. So when we were growing up, the little shows that were on PBS that we watched as kids, you know, not Saturday morning cartoons, so you had the Electric Company. Morgan Freeman was a big character on there. That was kind of like his first job. You had the Electric Company. You also had Sesame Street, which, by the way, did you see last night on 60 Minutes? They talked about Sesame Street having a new character. I can't remember the name of the character right now, but the character's going to have Down syndrome. And so, you know, they always try to address political issues with characters and the Muppets or whatever on Sesame Street. So Sesame Street, Electric Company, and then also you had the great Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, man. I'm talking 5, 6 years old. I'm talking 4, 5, 6 years old. Electric Company, Sesame Street, and then you also had Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. So I'm talking 1974. When your boy was 5 years old at the time, 73, 74, something like that. Watch those shows, man. Rest in peace to the great Fred Rogers. A couple of little side stories today, man. I talked about it. I mentioned it briefly earlier. FBI Director James Comey's appearance before the House Committee investigating Russian interference in the election happens today. So not only are they going to talk about this supposed interference with the election this year with Donald Trump, the orange dude, wound up being president, but they're also, he's supposed to address as well these accusations from the Trump administration that Barack Obama wiretapped Trump Hotel. Long story short, they're going to say it's all bullshit. They're going to say that the whole Trump Tower thing and Obama wiretapping Trump Tower is BS. And he hopefully is going to give some real credible evidence and conversation to this, you know, this relationship between Trump, his people, and Russia. So I'm going to be glued to the TV for that a little bit later on today. I always look forward to the Sean Spicer thing whenever I'm at the house and I don't have something I have to do. I go to the house and I watch Sean Spicer's daily report, the press secretary. I mean, that's absolute comedy. That happens today as well. And there was one more thing that I wanted to mention. You're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. And I know what it is. So, Donald Trump and his new budget. Remember we talked about HBCUs and how they took this trip to the White House and had this photo op with Donald Trump. And ultimately nothing came of it from that day. And all he did is recognize HBCUs for the great things that they had done in the past. And then he said, you know, we'll discuss what I'm going to do for HBCUs going forward in my new budget. And so basically the new budget maintains the amount of money that they spent, the government spent on HBCUs, but it's actually going to take away some of the funding for some of the programs. So at the end of the day, these HBCU presidents, man, and I actually have it posted on my Facebook page, these HBCU presidents got played, man. Now, we know funding for education is getting cut across the board for the most part. So to maintain what we had before, I guess, is a win. But there was nothing to there's no reason to have all of these HBCU presidents up there just to announce at the end of the day that we're going to keep the money the same when I think they asked for $26 billion. Right. HBCUs came together and asked for like $26 billion to kind of get them moving forward in the right direction. And not only did we not get $26 billion new dollars, but it stayed at the same amount of money that it was before. And I think that's like $420 million, if I remember the story. I don't have it in front of me. But also, funding is getting cut for some of the programs, like Pell Grants and all of those types of things, which students use to ensure that they could go to college. So, yeah, they got played. HBCU presidents got played like a fiddle. Like that wasn't necessary. The only institution that benefited from these HBCU presidents going to the White House, standing around Donald Trump and smiling like a chessy cat, the only person that benefited was Donald Trump and the way that the country views him. You know, the opposite of the situation is that there's a bunch of black people standing around Donald Trump and smiling. He must be doing good things for black people. It was a lie. It was a shell game. And lastly, man, have y'all heard about this? Y'all know who Lunell is? Lunell is the comedian that comes on the Tom Joyner Morning Show. She's going to pose nude in Penthouse Magazine. You heard me. If you don't know who Lunell is, man, she is funny as hell. She got that hard, raspy voice, kind of like sound like your grandmama or whatever, man. But, yeah, she's actually going to pose in Penthouse for their annual April Fool's edition. Now, I don't know if this whole thing means that it's not going to happen, and she's not going to pose in the magazine or not. It's some type of April Fool's joke. But here's a post on Instagram. She says, sorry, folks, Instagram took my other post down after all those wonderful comments, 456 comments. uh, right, let me back up for a second. So she actually posted a couple of these pictures on Instagram that are going to appear in this penthouse.